Hello, tangueros and tangueras from all over the world. Welcome to Patricio's and Eva's tango class. This is the time of the week that we are going to share very important information for you to improve your tango. So, Patricio.
Hola, Eva.
Hola.
Beautiful black and red combination.
¿Viste? Muy tangueros. Hoy estamos retangueros. Mírate, con las rayitas, todo.
Yes, we are exuding tango through our skin.
What happened?
Well, we just love tango.
Exactly. So today we have a very special class, which is the Boleo. The Boleo, the famous Boleo. Boleo is not only one thing. It's so complex that you have many different kind of Boleos, I will say, coming from different places. But we are going to focus today in the circular boleo, not in boleos in line or stuff like that. We are just going to really pay attention to our body mechanics to achieve boleos, back boleos and forward boleos. Mm-hmm. That's what we are trying to achieve in this almost 30 minutes class that we give you every week here. So let's see if we can. It's so much information. So open your ears, okay? And we are ready. How we start?
Well, boleo, like you said, is a rotating movement. And boleo is the action of throw the leg in the air. The name in Spanish, bolear, is just like a throw. So we use existing energy. We can do a boleo from a standing position, but if we are already turning, it's easier. So at the beginning, is used to use the energy that exists in the back ochos to do a back boleo. And you could use the energy existing in a front ocho to do a front boleo. When I learned the boleos a long time ago, some of my instructors were talking about boleo being an interrupt back ocho. And with that idea in mind, you could see that if you are reaching back to transfer your weight to do a back ocho, and you're reaching back to transfer your weight to do a back ocho, and you reach back, but then, I can do it,
okay.
But then when you reach back and then you don't transfer your weight, that's when the boleo exists. Meaning, you go back, transfer the weight, you reach, and then come back in. You go back, but you do not transfer the weight. If you go back and transfer the weight, it becomes a back step or a back ocho. But in the moment in which the follow reaches back and then reaches to the next step, and then she reaches to this step, but then I pull her up off the foot, then the change of direction is what creates that energy for the boleo. And the leg moves as a whipping sensation. It's a whipping action. It's like it goes slow and then it goes a little bit faster. Yeah. So if we want to do a very common way of doing this is outside the back ocho. So we go side step, the lead will transfer his weight to his right foot, and then as the lead reaches to the left, he creates a displacement because he pushes you backwards. And that makes you feel like that's what you need to follow. And then as the lead steps towards 2 o'clock, it makes the follow go over there. But in this one here, I make the attempt that I'm going, but I won't go. My hand here, if you can see my hand, see my friend, my hand waving at you in the back? Well, with this hand, I hold it onto her shoulder blade. So then when I go, I make my partner counter. So from my point of view, I go side step, transfer weight to my right step, then I do ochos, ochos, and in this one here, instead of pushing my partner, I reach only, giving the idea of a hint that I might take that step. But then the follows, who are used to reading your intentions, they can distinguish what you feel like when you are about to commit to going into a step and when you're holding off. When she sees the difference, she becomes more experienced, and you reach, but you stay, she will do the same thing. She will reach, and stay with you and not transfer her way. At that moment, when the leg is reaching out there, she then can flick. Mm-hmm. That's pretty much what happens. Back, side, one back ocho, two back ochos. The third one is about to happen. But it didn't. We created a boleo instead. Mm-hmm. So there is the nature of the boleo is the delay. It's a delay. You anticipate his actions, but then you move after the fact, meaning action, reaction, action, reaction, action, reaction. So in terms of rotation, I have to be very good at understanding where my partner's axis is, meaning foot and head are lined up. Foot and head. Foot and head. Foot, head. Now here, my partner is standing vertically in her axis. I have to make a turn counterclockwise, clockwise. Counterclockwise, clockwise. Counterclockwise, clockwise. So you have to understand, sadly, that you are not the center of the universe. In this moment, you have to make your partner the center of your universe. What do I mean by that? You have to turn around her axis. So, if she's standing in this axis, that means she cannot walk anymore because she has standing with her weight on her right foot. Now, I have 2 feet on the floor. So here, my partner is at the center of this turn, and the circle, and I can draw a circumference around my partner. As long as I'm standing with both of my feet on that circumference, as I move to the left, she goes clockwise, and as I move to my right, she goes counterclockwise. So, if the follow is relatively relaxed, there will be a delay between the spiral energy travels all the way to her feet, creating that supersonic effect that accelerates the flick of the boleo.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And for that, I want to show, that's very, very nice.
It's
and
a beautiful thing.
Extremely important thing. For the leads to understand the technique.
The spiral energy travels from the within the follow's body or the lead's body. It goes from shoulders to hip to foot. See, so you go counter. See, shoulder, hips, foot. Shoulder, hips, foot. Shoulders, his foot.
Yeah. And for that, I have one little exercise for the follows here.
Oh, beautiful.
That I wanted to show.
That's a great idea.
I think actually I will show it here. Just.
Okay. You want me to assist you in any way?
No. Actually, I want the other camera. Sorry about that. Because you can see my entire body, and this is what is important about it. I can show you here at the bar. Yeah, you can see me there. Yes. So for you to practice, this is an exercise to practice. Okay, you don't have a point of reference, so it's hard to understand where are you going. We are going to the maximum of our contra bodies. That's what we are trying to do. When we do boleos, we don't work as we don't align our hips and our torso. We don't move like everything together on a block. We move in a contra body. In a counterbody, as Patricio show you. If you want to do an exercise to kind of know where that maximum for you is, you can go to any furniture in your house or whatever you have room, and you can just do this. Stand perpendicular to the object you want to use for you to know your maximums, and then do this. Go forward with the leg here, and go away with your torso from the object you are holding to. And then go all the way to the opposite direction here. And then come back. And go all the way to the opposite direction. This is my maximum counterbody I can achieve, me personally. You need to understand which one is yours, okay? So from that extension there, which forced you to really be there with the hips, because it's very difficult to do if your hips are dropping. That's why I put the leg out there. Okay, so it forces you to kind of really look for this. Then you go all the way to the other side. So you kind of create that moment. Okay, and then you do it with the other leg. So you go with the leg forward, you look, okay, this is my counterbody here, this is my maximum. I will go to the other side, so here nothing, you are neutral, you see my hips and my torso is aligned, and then I keep going to the opposite direction. So this is my maximum. Here, a voleo could happen, see that? Yes, I could lift the leg or not. And then you go to the maximum, and you kind of create this, but that's the voleo right there. At the maximum of the counter body, that's what you're looking for. So this is very important because follow have a tendency to rush the hips to be right there, and not, they don't enjoy usually even feeling the lead kind of pull you to get off this position. We have sometimes a tendency to want to be there, right there, right? Fast, 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 fast. So I wanted to show you what Patricio showed before and what I'm doing when he's doing that, okay? When he interrupts my ocho, he interrupts it. He interrupts it at the moment I'm still extending there. But I don't shortcut my own movement. I actually complete that extension by the moment that the lead is already turning me to the opposite direction.
Okay? There is one principle, there are several principles, but one that is very important that is comes into place in this movement particularly. Mm-hmm. The shoulders lead your hips, or shoulders precede your hips. So as you're moving your along the ochos, the lead will turn your shoulder first. So shoulder makes you move your hip, you reach back, and then the shoulder pull makes you go forward. So there are actually five movements that you can count when you do your boleo. And you can think of, from the moment you go back and reach onto the first, onto the last ocho, you go one, two is the shoulder, three is the leg, four is the pivot, shoulder, and five is the stepping. So we can distinguish one, two, three, four, five. Mm-hmm. One, two, three, four, five. So you step on one, you step on three, and you step on five. One, two, three, four, five. Meaning you step on one, do boleo on three, and you step out of boleo on five. Mm-hmm. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five, where two and four are the upbeats and you are pivoting. So ocho, 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 one, two, three, four, five. We always in tango, on the default timing, we step every pair of beats, every two beats, meaning one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Where two, four, six, and eight are normally brushes. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five. You see? If I count from your last landing, this will be step, is the last back ocho preceding the boleo. Two is a pivot. Three is the boleo itself. Four is a pivot again. Five is the
exit.
Stepping out. Stepping. Where mm-hmm. on two and four, you will feel the maximum disassociation like you just demonstrated to our friends. You go one, two, sorry, three is disassociated, four, five is disassociated. Right? So you go from, actually, one is disassociated, two, three is disassociated, four, five. So disassociating on one, disassociating. Associating on three and dissociating on five.
It's difficult
so,
to say.
Dissociated, dissociated, dissociated. Mm-hmm. So for the lead, you go side together, back ocho, back ocho. Here, I understand where my partner is standing. So from the placement of my right foot and her axis, then I wrap close to her, and then rotate to the right. So what I do here is I go onto my right foot, turning left. And then I go onto my left foot, turning right. In this way, I am turning this wheel. And as I turn this wheel, my partner turns in it. Let me show you what I mean. Eva is standing in her axis here. And I go here, to the right and to the left. You see, this is what I mean turning the wheel. I transfer my weight onto my left hip. I transfer my weight onto my right hip. From right to left, from right to left. Turning Eva's axis. Right to left, left to right. Right to left, left to right. Left to left, left to right. To left, left to right. Should we dance so we can demonstrate this to our friends?
Let's
DJ,
dance.
Do you have a song in line? Yes? Good. Pugliese tonight, huh? Okay, you know I love Pugliese. Okay, well, we should do it.
Qué manera de hacer boleos, ¿no? Nos hicimos todos los boleos.
Well, that was nice.
Hicimos hasta boleos in line, everything like.
You might want to go back and look at that song.
Yeah.
Because if you blinked, you missed it. So, we talked about using the pre-existing energy of the back ochos to lead a back boleo. Eventually, you might free yourself up from that dependency. But if you're new to this, really, stepping past your follow to the side towards 10 o'clock and then rotating a little bit the shoulders and then stepping to the right and rotating a little bit like this helps her to cross and to pivot. So if your last ocho, my father used to have a joke that says, in which turn the dog goes to bed, go to sleep. You know, turn dogs like to...
Yeah, they turn around.
Turn around and then they see. Mm-hmm. So, and the answer was in the last one, right? I was a kid and I was thinking 3, 4, 5, 10. There is no number, right? And the same thing here. We said your last ocho is towards the right leg. Well, that only if you want to make it like that. See, you could do ochos and you could decide that your last ocho is to the right. Therefore, your next boleo will be as the lead lands on his left foot. But if the lead finds himself doing a boleo to his left foot, sorry, a back ocho towards his left foot, then as he lands on the right, then the follow will do boleo with the other leg. So let's show people again, in case they don't go back and see that song. We go back ocho. Back ocho, two back ochos is on my right leg. Boleo on Eva's left leg. But something less than common is to do boleo on the other leg. And I think it's important to have some variety, because when your partners, the ladies that dance with you, they figure out all your moves, it can get kind of boring. So it's important to, this is a mind game, right? So it's, the challenge is in the complexity sometimes. Mm-hmm. So if you do, instead of two, three ochos, then it goes on the other leg. One, two, three. This is going to be my last ocho, so that means the boleo mechanics are on the other leg.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right. And one thing that I wanted to say, because you can see I alter between low boleo and high boleo, and you know, often the question is how you know which one you had to do. Well, you don't really know, you know, like you decide which one you do. Actually, that's the simple answer to it. And I want to show the follows very quickly, the difference between one and the other. So as we are showing, I will take as an example this boleo. When Patricio interrupts my boleo, I kind of continue like kicking, you know, to complete that full extension of my leg that I talked before. So I don't shortcut my own boleo. I don't try to bring the leg as soon as he's sending me in that direction. But at this point, when I extend that leg, I have two options. Either I extend it through the floor and I keep it on the floor to keep moving, or I extend it through the floor, and this is the difference. I extend it through the floor, but I lift from my knee down, I lift my leg. That's basically what I'm doing. So nothing really changed. It's just I lift from my knee down or I don't do it. So if
you lengthen or bring it in, or lengthen, lift, and
correct,
then bring it in.
Yes.
I'm a good student, am I?
You are.
Thank you, my teacher.
So I will show you, if you can just stop there during the boleo, I can just show two versions. One is that one, and from here he brings me forward, or, which we don't need, he stopped me there and I keep going with the leg and he brings me forward. So it's my decision, basically, if
that's
I keep it
point
on the floor or I just lift my leg. That's the shape I want to go, I want to do to that boleo.
That's a good point, because follows, sometimes they are expecting the lead will tell, but it takes two to tango, and this is my tango as much as it is yours. I happen to be the lead, and we agreed that I was going to lead and you would follow. But you cannot follow in a very receptive way. You have to follow in an anticipating way. So you take control of your own movement, mm-hmm, right? When you move your boleo, you decide what boleo you're going to do. So you can do low boleos or high boleos. The suggestion that the lead could do is that if he does a very languid boleo or a very soft, lacking accent, then that might not have enough energy to actually pick up the leg. So maybe that's, but I can only hope.
That's the basic idea, because that's the point, right? Like we can decide anyways, because if it's very slow boleo, I might feel so inspired, instead of keeping it, I might leave it. I might do it anyways, in a slow motion. Like we are dancing,
yes,
in slow motion. I don't have the whip effect, the whip. You know, that boleo has that effect, like out of a sudden your leg kind of do a whip effect because the energy travels so fast that you kick in the air. That might not be present, but I create it by controlling my own muscles.
It's strength, it's not power, it's
exactly
strength.
So
at that
the
case,
end,
you still decide.
At the end, you can still decide to do a high boleo in a slow motion.
That's correct. Right. The lead can only hope. If the lead is energetic, he will hope that the follow will be more flamboyant or a little bit more energetic in her boleo as well. But mm-hmm, you could actually keep it low, completely ground to the floor, even if the lead is just requesting you to do it, because you know when it's safe and when it's not for you. So you got the last call.
Especially if you have high heels and for some reason you feel, oh, I don't know if this is safe.
This is not safe. This is not adequate for the moment, for me in this moment. I keep my foot on the ground. But even if the lead leads you very slowly and you feel like you want to go for it, then you can raise your leg and kick. It's your dance.
Correct. And before we go,
I want to demonstrate the, what do you want to say?
Yeah, okay, you want to demonstrate something.
Well, I want to demonstrate a very languid, low boleo because the mechanic is the same. For example, what I like to do on that is I bring you here to this forward end side step and I block. You see my right foot here, the one moving here? I'm blocking her foot over there. So from here, I move to the right slowly and then let her come onto my ankle and step over my foot and then go through that collection. And walk. Sometimes we want to go slower because the music, Pugliese, for example, could have a very nice rallentando where you got to drop that energy and not walk so often. Sometimes the dance floor is crowded, so you don't want to walk a lot. So many applications. Sometimes just the beauty of it. See, is that foot rolls to the floor, slow, here, and continue. Other times you get to the same position, you go whoosh, and you do it faster.
Yes, from the same position.
On the back ocho. Then also, having a little bit of flexibility here in the shoulders delays the passing of the energy. So it's a little bit like, remember the wave from the 90s? We're so retro. Let's do it again. Oh, I didn't do a good job.
The first one was good.
Anyway, I think we need to practice this.
You got the point.
Yes, we need to call Gigi for hip hop, Lionel and Regis, our friends, the breaker dancers.
Yeah.
But they get the point. There is a delay between the shoulders. The energy travels up from the top to the bottom. Top, bottom, bottom, top.
And this is worth to mention that when he does that, I feel I'm stationary here in this case. So what I will do is I will feel that energy on my torso and my leg. I need to delay that leg. If I connect my leg with my torso, then you don't really have a boleo. You don't have a spiral energy going through. So allow yourself to feel it in your torso and then the leg goes.
That was beautiful.
Delay that leg movement.
Also, it's beautiful to hear from our friends. I love receiving the support of our friends. They show us how much they care. They write message to us and they send their support. So this is a way to do it. You can make a donation through our Venmo account or our PayPal. And that way you will ensure that we will have the means to continue producing these videos to share with the entire world. Don't get me wrong, the classes are completely free. Everybody is welcome to watch and to learn. We want to share tango with everybody. But if you can make a donation and show your support so we can continue doing these videos, that will be grandiose.
Yes, and if you cannot, you can always subscribe, you can like, you can comment, you can help our channel grow because that brings more people into the community. Yes.
We are dancing all the time and we're producing events in Seattle and we are adding more classes and more activities as we speak. So we're not going to dance one more song so we can demonstrate people everything we spoke about. And our DJ, star DJ, DJ Patu, is going to play Recuerdo, one of my favorite songs. He knows me, he knows me.
Volumen.
Okay, guys, this was really great. As you can see, we only cover mostly the back boleo. Okay, boleos can be done in the front, and you can see in the videos, we did many of them, we show you. But the technique is the same. The idea is always to work with the counterbodies. The counterbodies are the most important thing. We might explain later the front boleo to give you more details about it. But I think it's plenty.
Maybe next week we can do front boleo.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Front ocho to front boleo. Front ocho to front boleo.
I think, yeah, it's worth it, actually, to share that, because it's something by itself.
Give us a comment. So if you want boleos to the front next week, let us know. Yes. We will be here dancing. We hope you do your part, and you will be there practicing with us.
Yes. Thank you for being there, always.
Ciao.
Mwah. Take care.
Sonrisitas.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.